Yes.
Of course, please.
Mrs. Pearson, calmly. It was, now it isn't. 40 hours a week for all now. Just watch it and the weekend. When I have my 2 days off. Doris and Siri exchange alarm glances. Then they stare at Mrs. Pearson, who turns their look calmly. Siri.
What's that? Something to eat. Look, as if I will need to keep my strength up.
Siri exits to the kitchen. Doris, moving to the set and see a sleep.
Mom, you told me you were not going to anything on Saturday and Sunday.
Mrs. Pearson, airily. No, I wouldn't go that far. I might make a bed or two and do a bit of cooking as a favor. Which means, of course, I will have to be asked very nicely and thanked for everything and generally made a fuss of. But any of you 40-hour workers who expect to be waited on hand and foot on Saturday and Sunday with no thanks for it are in for a nasty disappointment. Might go off for the weekend perhaps.
That is must.
Go off for the weekend.
Go off for the weekend.
Mrs. Pearson. Why not? I could do with a change. Stuck here day after day, week after week. If I don't need a change, who does?
Doris.
But where will you go? Who will you go?
Who will you go with?
Mrs. Pearson. That's my business. You don't ask me where you should go and who you should go with, do you?
Doris.
That's different.
Mrs. Pearson. The only difference is that I'm a lot older and better able to look after myself. So it's you who should do the asking.
Girls.
Will you follow me yourself with something?
Mrs. Pearson told me.
No, but I'll hit you with something. Girl, if you don't stop asking silly questions.
Doris stares at her open mouth, ready to cry. Girls.
Oh, it's our fault.
She begins to cry, not passionately. Mrs. Pearson coldly.
Stop blubbering. You're not a baby. If you're old enough to go out with Charlie Spence, you're old enough to behave properly. Now stop it.
Just Pearson enters left. He is about 50, fundamentally decent, but gentleman, self-important, pompous. Preferably, he should be a heavy, slow-moving man. He notices Doris's tears. Judge.
Hello. What's this? Can't be anything to cry about.
Hello. What is this? Can't be anything to cry about. Doris. Through sobs.
You will see.
Doris runs out left because some are two on the way. Judge stares. After her a moment, the news happens. Judge.
Did she say, you will see?
Mrs. Pearson.
Yes.
Judge.
What did she mean?
Mrs. Pearson.
Better ask her.
Judge, you slowly again at the door. They have Mrs. Pearson. Then he notices the shout when Mrs. Pearson raises for another seat. His eyes almost bulge. Judge.
Stout?
Mrs. Pearson.
Yes.
Judge, amazed.
What are you drinking? Stout for?
Mrs. Pearson.
Because I have assigned some.
Judge.
At this time of day?
Mrs. Pearson.
Yes. What's wrong with it at this time of day?
Judge, be wilder.
Nothing, I suppose. I mean. But I have never seen you to do it before.
Mrs. Pearson.
Well, you're seeing me now?
Judge, with heavy step.
Yes, I'm not. I don't like it. It does not look right. I am surprised at
it. Mrs. Pearson.
Well, that ought to be a nice change for you.
Judge.
What do you mean?
Mrs. Pearson.
It must be some time since you were surprised at me, George.
Judge.
I don't like surprises.
has got his feelings. Fine too.
Mrs. Pierce, sometimes it does people good to have their feelings hurt. The truth ought not to hurt anybody for long. If your father didn't go to the club so often, perhaps they would stop laughing at him. See him gloomily.
I doubt it.
Mrs. Pierce, severely. Possibly you do. But what I doubt is whether your opinion's worth having. What do you know? Nothing. You spend too much time and good money at great road races and dirt tracks and icy shows. Cyril, softly.
Well, what if I do? I have got to enjoy myself. Somehow I haven't tried.
Somehow, how are you doing? Mrs. Pearson, I wouldn't mind so much if you were really enjoying yourself. But are you? And where's it getting you?
There is a song for it now, heard of lift, Cyril.
Might be. For me, I'll see.
Cyril hurries up lift. In a moment, he re-enters, closing the door behind him.
Mr. Cyril, or that from next door?
Mrs. Fizzle,
you don't want here.
You don't want her here? Do you? Mrs. Fizzle, sadly. Certainly I do. Ask her in and don't call her a silly old bag either. She's a very nice woman with a lot more sense than you will ever have.
Cyril exits, left. Mrs. Pearson finishes her stove, smacking her lips. Cyril re-enters lift, ushering in Mrs. Fizzle, who hesitates in the doorway. Mrs. Fizzle, moving to left center, anxiously.
I just wondered if everything was alright.
When you were ending with the dialogue, you just knew that thought. To whom? You are telling, okay? Mrs. Fizzler, Cyril, softly.
No, please.
Yes, very good. Mrs. Pearson, softly.
Of course it is. You keep quiet.
Cyril, indignantly and loudly.
Why should I be quiet?
Very good. Mrs. Pearson, shouting.
Because I tell you to. You silly, spoiled, young person?
Mrs. Fizzle protesting nervously.
Oh, now, sorry.
Mrs. Pearson, severely.
Now, Mrs. Fizzle, just let me manage my family in my own way. Please.
Mrs. Fizzle,
yes, I'll say it.
Cyril, softly and lowly, lowly.
Mr. Cyril, dear sir. Will you please, Mrs. Fizzle?
Cyril stalks up into the kitchen. Mrs. Fizzle moving to the set, peacefully.
Oh dear, what's happening?
Mrs. Pearson, calmly. Nothing much. Just putting them in their faces. That's all. Doing what you ought to have done long since.
Mrs. Fizzle.
Judge, ma'am.
She sits beside Mrs. Pearson on the steps. Mrs. Pearson.
Yes, I have been telling him what they think of him at the club.
Mrs. Fizzle.
Yes, they think a lot of him, don't they?
Mrs. Pearson. No, they don't. And now he knows it.
Mrs. Fizzle nervously.
Oh dear, I wish you had him, Mrs. Pearson.
Mrs. Pearson.
Nonsense. Doing them all a world of good and they'll be eating out of your hands soon. You'll see.
Mrs. Pearson.
I don't think I want them eating out of my hand.
Mrs. Pearson impatiently.
Well, whatever you want, they'll be doing it. All three of them. Mark my words, Mrs. Pearson.
George enters left gloomily. He is unpleasantly surprised. When he sees the vision, he moves to the armchair leg, sits down heavily and gloomily lies.
just tell me that. And is not it bad enough without her calling me job? No tea, only person. And poor Doris has been crying her eyes out of upstairs. Yes, crying her eyes out.
Mrs.
Fisher
and
poor dear, I ought to have one.
George, staring at her annoyed.
You ought to have no. Why ought you to have no? Nothing to do with you, Mrs. Fisher. Look, we are at 6s and 7s. We here just now, so perhaps you will excuse us.
Mrs. Pearson, before Mrs. Fisher can reply,
I won't excuse you, George Pearson. Next time a friend and a neighbor comes to see me, just say something when you see her. Good evening, or how do you do? Or something, and don't just march in and sit down without a word. It's bad manners.
Mrs. Fitzgerald murmurs.
Oh, it's alright.
Mrs. Pearson.
No, it isn't alright. We'll have some decent manners in this house, or I'll know the reason why.
Glaring at George.
Well, what?
Mrs. Pearson, darling.
Why don't you get off to your club? Special night tonight, isn't it? They'll be waiting for you, wanting to have a good laugh. Go on then, don't disappoint them.
George, be down.
That's right. Make me look silly in front of her now. Go on, don't mind me. Sixes and sevens. Poor Doris been crying her eyes out. Getting the neighbors into see the fun.
Suddenly losing his temper, glaring at Mrs. Pearson and shouting.
All right, let her hear it. What's the matter with you? Have you gone balmy?
What's the matter with you? Have you gone balmy?
Or what?
Pahoot, Mrs. Pearson, jumping up savagely.
If you shout at me again like that, George Pearson, I'll slap your big fat silly face.
Mrs. Fisher, moaning.
Oh, no, please.
Mrs. Fisher sits, George staring at her, given.
I am off my charm, or you who are. You won't now mean no, please. Mrs. Fisher, look, you are Mrs. Fisher. So why are you telling yourself to stop when you are not doing anything? Tell her to stop. Then there will be something sensible.
Staring at Mrs. Pearson?
I think you must be delirious.
Mrs. Pearson staring up savagely.
Say that again, George Pearson.
George, intimidated.
All right.
Doris enters, left, slowly, looking miserable. She is still wearing the frock. Mrs. Pearson sits on the stage. Mrs. Fitzgerald.
Hello, Doris, dear.
Doris, miserably.
Hello, Mrs. Fitzgerald.
I thought you were going out with Charlie. That's all you had.
Doris, annoyed.
What's that to do with you?
What is that to do with you? Mrs. Pearson, sharply. Stop that. Mrs. Fitzgerald, marvelously.
No, it's alright.
Mrs. Pearson, severely.
It isn't alright. I won't have a daughter of mine talking to anybody like that. Now answer Mrs. Fitzgerald properly. Doris, or go upstairs again.
Doris looks wonderingly at her father, George, in despair.
Don't look at me. I give it up. I just give it up.
Mrs. Pearson, fiercely.
Well, answer her.
Doris, sulkily.
I was going out with Charlie Spence tonight. But now I have called it off.
Mrs. Fisher.
Oh, what a pity, dear. Why have you?
Doris, with a flask of temper.
Because, if you might know, my mother's been going on at mimicking.
Mother has been going on at mimicking. Me feel miserable. I'm saying he's got her teeth and is half-witted. Mrs. Fisher, rather bolder to Mrs. Pearson.
Oh,
Mrs. Pizza.
No, I can't stand any more of it. It's really, I really can't. We must
no, change. I can't stand any more of it. I really can't. We must change back. Mario, please.
Thank you.